My name is Claudio Punzo. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Massachusetts Medical School in Worcester. And in this study, we are looking at the disease retinitis pigmentosa, which is a devastating disease that leads to blindness characterized by the massive loss of rod and cone photoreceptors. In the retina, the relationship of rods and cones is such that when rods die, cone death always follows. Whereas if cones die, rods don't really care about it. And this is important in retinitis pigmentosa because many people are affected by mutation in rod-specific genes, meaning that they also lose cone vision, which is daylight and high acuity vision. And we have previously proposed that cone death is due to the collapse of the outer nuchal layer and subsequent starvation of cones due to reduced nutrient flow. What we think is happening is that once rods are dying and the outer nuchal layer is collapsing, the retinal pigmented epithelium, which is the adjacent cell layer, is not providing enough nutrients to cones, and cones are slowly starving to death. And what we have shown previously is that the insulin mTOR pathway seems to be playing a crucial role during cone death. And as a proof of principle at the time, we injected insulin in mice to see if that could prolong cone survival. And what happened was that we got sustained cone survival for a period of 4 weeks, but when we did the experiment for a longer period, 7 weeks, cone survival was not there anymore. The difference of that experiment to the experiment now is that instead of activating the pathway systemically because insulin was injected into the mouse, it would activate the pathway everywhere, we now activate the pathway in cones and remove the feedback loop. So we can see if actually the pathway was acting directly in cones, and we can see if by keeping the pathway active, do we get sustained cone survival as compared to previously, where we had only a short period of cone survival, most likely due to the feedback loop within the pathway.
My name is Aditya, Venkatesh, and I'm a graduate student in the lab of Claudio Punzo. So here we performed a comprehensive study where we deleted various components downstream of the insulin mTOR pathway and studied their effect to cone survival. And we specifically found that by activating the pathway by two different approaches, by loss of P10, which would activate both mTOR complexes, and by loss of TSC, which would only activate mTOR complex 1, we were able to significantly prolong cone survival for up to 8 months of age. In particular, constitutive activation of only mTOR complex 1 by loss of TSC was able to robustly prolong cone survival, especially in the fast-progressing RD1 mouse model of degeneration. Moreover, this survival effect was not limited to just one model. We also achieved significant protection in a slower degenerating model, namely the rhodopsin knockout. So this suggests that the approach of rescuing cones by activating mTOR complex 1 could be applicable against a wide spectrum of mutations in the disease.
The reason why we're really excited about this study is that we got an unparalleled rescue in cone survival in the RD1 mouse model, and the rescue worked also in the rhodopsin knockout model, which tells us that by improving cell metabolism, we can really extend cone survival in a way that will be therapeutically beneficial to patients in the future.